Mesothelioma is a type of cancer that develops from the thin layer of tissue that covers many of the internal organs, known as the mesothelium. The most common area affected is the lining of the lungs and chest wall. Less commonly the lining of the abdomen, and rarely the sac surrounding the heart, or the sac surrounding the testis may be affected. Signs and symptoms of mesothelioma may include shortness of breath due to fluid around the lung, a swollen abdomen, chest wall pain, cough, feeling tired, and weight loss. These symptoms typically come on slowly. Greater than 80% of mesothelioma cases are caused by exposure to asbestos. The greater the exposure, the greater the risk. As of 2013, about 125 million people have been exposed to asbestos at work. High rates of disease occur in people who mine asbestos, produce products from asbestos, work with asbestos products, live with asbestos workers, or work in buildings containing asbestos. Often it is around 40 years between exposure and the cancer starting. Washing the clothing of someone who worked with asbestos also increases the risk. Other risk factors include genetics and infection with the simian virus 40. The diagnosis may be suspected based on chest X-ray and CT scan findings, and is confirmed by either examining fluid produced by the cancer or by a tissue biopsy of the cancer. Prevention centers around reducing exposure to asbestos. Treatment often includes surgery, radiation therapy, and chemotherapy. A procedure known as pleurodesis, which involves using substances such as talc to scar together the pleura, may be used to prevent more fluid from building up around the lungs. Chemotherapy often includes the medications cisplatin and pemetrexed. The percentage of people that survive 5 years following diagnosis is on average 8% in the United States. In 2013, about 50,000 people had mesothelioma and 34,000 died from the disease. Rates of mesothelioma vary in different areas of the world. Rates are higher in Australia, the United Kingdom, and lower in Japan. It occurs in about 3,000 people per year in the United States. It occurs more often in males than females. Rates of disease have increased since the 1950s. Diagnosis typically occurs after the age of 65, and most deaths occur around 70 years old. The disease was rare before the commercial use of asbestos. Working with asbestos is the most common risk factor for mesothelioma. In the United States, asbestos is considered the major cause of malignant mesothelioma and has been considered indisputably associated with the development of mesothelioma. Indeed, the relationship between asbestos and mesothelioma is so strong that many consider mesothelioma a signal or sentinel tumor. A history of asbestos exposure exists in most cases. However, mesothelioma has been reported in some individuals without any known exposure to asbestos. In rare cases, mesothelioma has also been associated with irradiation of the chest or abdomen, intrapleural thorium dioxide, thorotrast as a contrast medium, and inhalation of other fibrous silicates, such as arionide or talc. Some studies suggest that simian virus 40, SV40, may act as a cofactor in the development of mesothelioma. This has been confirmed in animal studies, but studies in humans are inconclusive. Pericardial mesothelioma may not be associated with asbestos exposure. Asbestos was known in antiquity, but it was not mined and widely used commercially until the late 19th century. Its use greatly increased during World War II. Since the early 1940s, millions of American workers have been exposed to asbestos dust. Initially, the risks associated with asbestos exposure were not publicly known. However, an increased risk of developing mesothelioma was later found among naval personnel, for example, Navy, Marine Corps, and Coast Guard, shipyard workers, people who work in asbestos mines and mills, producers of asbestos products, workers in the heating and construction industries, and other tradespeople. Today, the official position of the U.S. Occupational Safety and Health Administration, OSHA, and the U.S. EPA is that protections and permissible exposure limits required by U.S. regulations, while adequate to prevent most asbestos-related non-malignant disease, are not adequate to prevent or protect against asbestos-related cancers such as mesothelioma. Likewise, the British government's Health and Safety Executive, HSE, states formally that any threshold for exposure to asbestos must be at a very low level, and it is widely agreed that if any such threshold does exist at all, then it cannot currently be quantified. For practical purposes, therefore, HSE assumes that no such safe threshold exists. Others have noted as well that there is no evidence of a threshold level below which there is no risk of mesothelioma. There appears to be a linear dose-response relationship, with increasing dose producing increasing disease. Nevertheless, mesothelioma may be related to brief, low-level or indirect exposures to asbestos. The dose necessary for effect appears to be lower for asbestos-induced mesothelioma than for pulmonary asbestosis or lung cancer. Again, there is no known safe level of exposure to asbestos as it relates to increased risk of mesothelioma. The duration of exposure to asbestos-causing mesothelioma can be short. For example, cases of mesothelioma have been documented with only 1-3 months of exposure. People who work with asbestos wear personal protective equipment to lower their risk of exposure. Latency, the time from first exposure to manifestation of disease, is prolonged in the case of mesothelioma. It is virtually never less than 15 years and peaks at 30-40 years. In a review of occupationally related mesothelioma cases, the median latency was 32 years. Based upon the data from Pito et al., the risk of mesothelioma appears to increase to the third or fourth power from first exposure. Mesothelioma is generally resistant to radiation and chemotherapy treatment. Long-term survival and cures are exceedingly rare. Treatment of malignant mesothelioma at earlier stages has a better prognosis. Clinical behavior of the malignancy is affected by several factors, including the continuous mesothelial surface of the pleural cavity, which favors local metastasis via exfoliated cells, invasion to underlying tissue and other organs within the pleural cavity, and the extremely long latency period between asbestos exposure and development of the disease. The histological subtype and the patient's age and health status also help predict prognosis. The epithelioid histology responds better to treatment and has a survival advantage over sarcomatoid histology. Surgery, by itself, has proved disappointing. In one large series, the median survival with surgery, including extrapleural pneumonectomy, was only 11.7 months. However, research indicates varied success when used in combination with radiation and chemotherapy, Duke, 2008. Or with one of the latter. A pleurectomy / decortication is the most common surgery, in which the lining of the chest is removed. Less common is an extrapleural pneumonectomy, EP, in which the lung, lining of the inside of the chest, the hemidiaphragm and the pericardium are removed. In localized pericardial mesothelioma, pericardectomy can be curative. When the tumor has metastasized, pericardectomy is a palliative care option. The entire tumor is not often able to be removed. Mesothelioma often has a poor prognosis. Typical survival despite surgery is between 12 and 21 months depending on the stage of disease at diagnosis, with about 7.5% of people surviving for 5 years. Some people who were exposed to asbestos have collected damages for an asbestos-related disease, including mesothelioma. Compensation via asbestos funds or class action lawsuits is an important issue in law practices regarding mesothelioma.